If we bring in a piece of music that is longer than we like say more than 30 seconds or 30 seconds, but we want the front part and the end part, but just cut out some of the bits in the middle. How do we do this? That is really easy. And recently, Descript made that even easier. So I'm going to show you really here, really quickly. I'm just going to go and extract a little bit of clip here from this composition. Okay, just to exemplify what I wanted to show you. Here we go. That is a piece of composition here. I'm going to make the timeline, expand the timeline. So my advice is, if you add music and you need to synchronize the music with your content in Descript, use the timeline. Okay, so go to the bottom, show timeline right there in the corner, and reveal your timeline. You can make it taller, make enough room for yourself to work on, because it's much easier to work in the timeline. Okay, so if you want to put music there, the easiest way to do is to locate the music file, bring it from your disk, or let's say, you know, you go to your stock media library and bring something from your stock media. I have a bunch of files in here already loaded as a music file. So I'm just going to grab one of these. I'm just going to grab this file and drag it down there in the timeline above the script track, right? So you see my file is right there. And I only want to use maybe the first part, the intro, and then a piece from the outro, like a start and finish kind of thing. Well, you can always do this. Just grab the end of the file and shorten it, right? Let's see. If you just want to use the beginning, I'm just going to drag all of that there. And look at this. It is a very short piece. If I play it, all right.
Advanced, specializes in.
Okay, so you can see this is a very short music clip. So you can always drag the edges of the clip to reveal more or less of that clip. But how about if I want to use a piece of the music and then another piece from somewhere else? This is really cool because you can make it so that that clip stays in one piece. Here's how you do it. And by the way, to show you better, you can go here to layer size and make it large so you can see even better. And I like to look at the waveform when I edit music stuff, right? So here's how you do it. Select that music clip and then you switch to the range tool. The range tool is here on the top right of the timeline, or you press R. And watch this. If I make a selection on this music file, okay, let me show you. I'm going to drag and make a selection like this. You see, I have selected just a portion of that music file. And you notice that it's highlighted. If I delete that now, look at this, press delete or backspace, I have removed that selection. Okay, so that's step one. But look at this. If you zoom in, you can see now that this part of it is like cut off. That's where my cut was. And it's two cuts, two pieces of clip. But if you look above this thing at the top, it shows me that it's still part of the same file and it's still one clip. Watch this. If I switch back to the select tool and I try to move this, look at this. It just moves together. Both of those clips move together, right? So this is one way to do this. You are making a cut using the range tool on that clip and just collapsing the rest of it. And how do I adjust? Maybe, you know, I want to say, oh, I want a piece from the middle. Okay, well, I'm just going to make another selection. Let's say I'm going to cut all the way to the end right there, but not quite the end. Delete again. You see now, my clip actually now has two cuts on it, one here and one here. And this is the nice part. If you want to control sort of the timing of these cuts, you know you need it to be like a minute long or 30 seconds long, but you want to play with the timing. That is where the other tool comes in, and it's called the slip tool. The slip tool is right here next to the range tool, and you press Y. And look at this. If I go down here in the timeline on these clips, I can click on each one of them individually. And with the slip tool, if I click and drag, look what happens. I am actually moving the music inside of that segment, right? Left or right, to control where it starts and where it begins. So that is really great because it's a very precise control of the music. And you can go all the way, even all the way to the end. Look, if I keep going, look, now I have revealed the end of the file. So in every one of these segments, the entire file shows up. So I can change the timing. I can move it left. I can move it right. I can go all the way to the end if I want to, or to the beginning. And that's really nice because while you can do all these things, you can save this whole clip with those cuts as a part of the template and reuse it. And if you do like a let's call it looping, you know, people used to do that in the past. They still do it, musicians. You have a piece of music and then you find a repeatable loop in that file and you have it repeat over and over and over. Well, you can kind of do that here. You can take one piece of music and then just kind of move it around and make sure the cuts fall in the right place and you create that. What this gives you is all of these three segments, like I have here, they can have their own transitions. Watch this. You can see these little dots in the corners. I can create a fade out or a fade in, and you can do a crossfade. If you pull on the opposite direction of a clip, so watch this. I'm going to clip on the middle clip, the circle in the corner, and now I pull towards the left. I am actually creating a crossfade between those two. Watch what happens. Here we go. You can kind of hear those beats, double the beats, because the music isn't quite synchronized according to the beat. But that was a crossfade between them two. Or if I want just a simple fade, I will go to the beginning here and I will fade the beginning like that. So you can hear the music fading in now. There you go. So I faded the music in. I can fade it out at the end, right there. And I can fade in the middle. I can do whatever I want in this. And at the end of the day, this is part of the same object. Look, I'm moving this around and all of those transitions go with it. All of those crossfades, everything goes with it. It keeps all the offsets. This is really convenient for a lot of use cases. And by the way, if you don't like this middle bit, if you don't want it in there, you can click on it and just delete it. And now everything collapses to those two pieces. So these segments, you can individually take them out. And if you need to put them in, you can pull it back or reveal some more from the left side. And the whole clip just expands to fit whatever you are doing. So this is very easy to find little loopable portions, right? Look, if I look in here on the timeline, I can kind of see this is the beginning here. And then there's an end to this loop right there. So if I want to, I can just cut that out like this. And then I will go to the beginning and collapse that bit there. Like that. So, and I just remove this segment right there. So look, this is a kind of a loopable piece, right? Oh, and it's fading in. So, right? So it ends like this, right? So I have that kick drum in here. I can take that out very carefully. And now look at this. If I take this and I copy it, Command V to paste. I have pasted it twice. And if I approach it like this, they will play one after the other. Don't overlap them, but look at this. So it seamlessly went into the second piece. So, you know, you can use the waveform to look at the sound and create a little loopable thing if you want to use it, like for a background music, but you don't have a very long piece. I usually do it in Camtasia when I do my tutorials or something like that. If I need to have a piece of music go on for longer than it is, I will identify a piece of the music that I can repeat seamlessly. And I copy and paste that over and over and over. And it's like an endless loop of the same piece. That's kind of what they do in music, in the music industry. Here we go. I hope I clarified that question for you. You can do very precise cuts with music, but use the timeline, okay? You cannot do these kinds of things in the script area.